Denver, the plane's going out full, so if you have stuff on the middle seat thinking nobody's going to sit next to you, move it now. Because somebody's going to sit there. Unless you bought two seats, and if you didn't, I'll sell it to you for $300 right now. You can have an extra seat next to you. All right, see, now you're moving that stuff. You can see. Quick flight to Denver today. I don't know how far it is. It's about over the mountain, through the woods, and out there. Probably about like 3 hours, 92 minutes to get there, but we'll get there.
Comment below if you guys love Southwest. Pilot's just messing around with us.
Offer an airplane mode. Flight attendants, have doors for departure and cross check, please.
Doors arm across, check for pushback. Seatbelt insert the flattening into the buckles, release lift up on the buckles. Seatbelt should be worn low and tight across the center hips and all times while seated. We're equipped with 6 emergency exits, 2 forward exit doors, 2 over wing window exits, 2 rear exit doors. Signs overhead and lights on the floor will lead you to an exit. In event of an emergency evacuation, follow your flight attendants. We'll be running out the front, the back, beside any possible door hole of the aircraft to get out of here and go home. Now, since we might fly over some water between here and Denver, it is really cool lake vests. They're located underneath your seats. Only take a moment until you do so. Be pulling onto the red strap bucket to see which opens the container. Take out the pouch, flashing out the vest for the vest over your head. Secure the black strap around your waist. Once outside the aircraft, pull down on the red tab to inflate the vest or blow into the tube of your shoulder. Also, there's a really cool light on the left-hand shoulder that starts blinking. Helps the sharks find you, so make sure you get it completely wet. Our flight attendants are coming by right now because we don't trust you. And to double check to make sure your seatbelts are securely fastened. Seat backs and tree tables in the full upright lock position. And all those carry items that you could have checked at the curb for free to instead drag through the entire airport now crammed in the overhead bin or underneath the seat in front of you, keeping the air around you being completely clear but making it impossible to stretch our legs and be comfortable. Smoking's gross. Plus, the government says you cannot do it aboard our aircraft. For the law prohibits temporary disabling the furnace smoke detector aboard this aircraft. Federal aviation regulations also require passenger compliance with all lighted passenger information signs, posted placards, and everything we ask you to do. Got it? Got it?
Yeah.
Hello?
Good. Also, folks, there are 2 lavatories aboard the aircraft. The lavatory is a very sophisticated word that Boeing likes to use for outhouse aboard an aircraft. There's 1 up front, 1 in the back. The 1 up front, we ask you do not stand formerly or later in the front galley area. We do appreciate your cooperation with that.
And although we never anticipate a change in cabin pressure, should one occur, four yellow oxygen masks will drop right above your head. To activate, pull down on the mask, fully extending the plastic tube, and place the mask over your nose and mouth and breathe like you've never breathed before. Although the plastic bag may not inflate, you are receiving oxygen. Keep use of oxygen until otherwise instructed by a uniform crew member. If you're traveling with children, somebody duty in special assistance, place your mask on first, then secure theirs. Moms and dad, travel with the whole family? Why? No, seriously, Mom, you know how it is. Place your mask on first, secure the children, then look at your husband. We won't let you make the decision on that one. All right, folks, we wish you some back relax and just quick flight to Denver. Flight time is calculated from takeoff and landing. The captain's, I think we get like 2 hours and 20 minutes or something. Actual flight time is 2 hours once we're in the air. Welcome aboard, 141.
on behalf of Southwest Airlines and the Chicago-based crew, like to welcome you to Denver. Please remain in your original seats, like you're gonna get up and walk around right now, but some people do, until the captain brings the aircraft to complete stop at the gate and turns off the fasten seatbelt sign. Please be careful opening overhead bin compartments as things do have a tendency of shifting, could fall out, slap you upside the head, you'd forget how wonderful we've been to you for the last, I don't know, 2 hours and 18 minutes of your life. If you have a connection, please plain check the TV monitors located in the terminal for flight information. Those passengers going on to St. Louis with us, I don't know, there's a handful of you. Please remain in your original seats. Allow the local passengers to deplane. Once they've done so, we'll get a quick through count, and we'll start to load our local passengers and get this plane on out of here to St. Louis because we're just tired at this point. We just need to keep going, so you know what I mean? Folks, it's certainly been a pleasure serving most of you. There was a couple of you that decided to sleep the entire flight, so next time you want to do something crazy like put yourself in a pressurized aluminum tube and go shooting across a few states, think of us here at Southwest Airlines. Go out, have a wonderful evening, be kind to one another, use a turn signal. Welcome to Denver, the Mile High, the Mile High City. Alright, love you, bye. Okay, folks, we're here. Everyone get out. Flight attendants, disarm doors for arrival.
All right, time for flight number 2. Okay.
All right, did anyone look around and look up here? Just wanted to get your attention. Okay, now that, now that I have your attention, we'd like to welcome this Boeing 737 temperature aircraft to visit the information card in your seatbelt pocket. And to fasten your seatbelt, slide the flag into the buckle, hold on to the disruptor tag and to release the top onto the buckle. Position your seatbelt low and tie the cross so you can turn around any time you are seated. If you guys will have access to back to side, then please literally get out of here. Two phone exit doors to open with your exit and to exit doors to the back. Sign to my advice on the floor with the church and exit. If an evacuation is necessary, follow. If an evacuation is necessary, follow the flight attendant's commands and leave everything. And the event of a water evacuation, there's a life vest under your seat. We both allow only so to do so for the rest trapped within the container as shown in the safety information card. Place the vest over your head, wrap the strap around your waist, buckle it in the front, and pull to tiny. Once outside, put the red tab to enter the vest, and to manage the equipment to do two by your shoulders. And there's a line that is attached to each vent that will turn on automatically in the water, and that will track all the sharks. Please refer to the safety information card for these other life vests on a different, and if actual life vests is needed, flight attendants will pass them out. And at this time, our models are going to come to the cabin to check that your shoes matches your outfit. Your seatbelt securely fastened, your seat back and tray tables are in the full or final position, and all carrying items completely stored underneath the seat in front of you or in your headband, keeping the area around your feet clear. Walking, including e-cigarettes, is not allowed, including the laboratory. Federal or prohibited security discipline or destroyed any smoke detectors and aircraft laboratories. Federal aviation regulations require passenger compliance with aligned information signs, with their placards, and command instructions, including information on seatbelts and smoking. And also, it is prohibited to consume your own alcohol that you have brought on board with you. So if we did not pass those little bottles to you, we don't want to see them, it's not worth it. And if needed, for oxygen mask will drop from the compartment overhead. If that happens, it's okay, and stop screaming and let go of your neighbor. Just pull out of the mask and lift it over your nose and mouth and redoubling. Take out the mask with the elastic strap. All the oxygen will flow in the plastic bag when oxygen inflates. Continue the mask until all the rises are back, remember. If you travel children or anyone acting like a child, please remember to put on your mask first. That's it, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, these are the dudes and the girls at that time. And remember, we are here for your safety and your comfort. So at this time, we'd like to sit back, relax, and enjoy your 2 hours and 10 minutes flight. To New Orleans, welcome aboard Southwest Airlines. Thank you.
Let the good time roll. Have fun, guys.